If you'd asked me 10 years ago when I started my lab that I'll be, you know, I'll have a 1 kilometer tunnel and recording from a whole colony of bats, I'll tell you you're nuts. I'm studying the hippocampal formation, a set of brain areas that have to do with learning and memory. And I'm studying those brain areas in somewhat unusual animal models in bats. Bats, I think they're very cute. The bats that we work with, the Egyptian fruit bats, have these interesting behaviors that we try to utilize and that give advantages over the standard animal models, which are mice and rats. So for example, if we want to ask questions about how 3D space, three-dimensional space is represented in the brain, bats are flying mammals, so obviously they're a good choice for that. We can also, another advantage is that bats have two distal sensory systems, vision and echolocation. We can trade off these two senses and ask how the same space is represented under these two systems, which are difficult to do in rats or mice. We can also ask questions about how very large spaces are represented in the brain. So we've built this long tunnel, 200 meter long, and we are building this year an even longer tunnel, almost 1 kilometer long, and we have bats flying there 100 or 120 times back and forth while we record neurons in their brain, and we see, you know, very different representation in this enormous space. So we implant these small electrodes in the bats that allow us to record the activity of single neurons in those brain areas. And we have developed these small wireless electrophysiology devices called neurologgers that are really small and sit on top of the animal, which allow us to record wirelessly in a bat as it is flying around. And then we can have them fly in a large flight room or in various large-scale spaces that we've built and studied their representation of space. We can also have bats interacting and ask more social questions on the bats. What I'm really interested in is the neural basis of natural behaviors. You know, neuroscience have traditionally focused on either, of course, kind of anesthetized animals, animals that don't behave at all, or if they're, you know, doing behaviors, they're doing highly controlled behaviors, you know, lever pressing or nose poking in some very, you know, 30 centimeter size box. The big plus side of it is that it's highly controlled, so you can get very repeated and very controlled experiment. The minus side of it is it's very far removed from natural behavior, from what the brain evolved to actually do outdoors. And so I really believe, in addition to having those highly controlled experiments, we should ideally record the same neurons, or at least from the same brain areas, from an animal behaving in a more natural situation. Now that the technology allows it, that we have technology for wireless electrophysiology, for recording for freely moving animals, you know, from wireless optogenetics, camera arrays, with microphone, with movement sensors, all sorts of devices that were not available until a few years ago, we can really study the neural base of behavior for the first time, for real.